Now, here's a map of Asia. Looks like a lot of countries, and it can be confusing, but we're going to make things a lot simpler for ourselves by picking out a few countries that are going to be our anchor countries. Those are the big countries on the map, and we're going to use those countries as a way of being able to study the others around them. The anchor countries we're going to choose for this map are the three that we hear the most about, and those are China, India, and Japan. Those are going to be our three anchor countries. We'll learn all of our other countries just by their proximity to our three anchor countries. Now, we start in the north. So we'll go from top to bottom with the countries that are close to China. First of all, we have North Korea and South Korea. They're on the Korean Peninsula, which kind of sticks out from China there in the direction of Japan. Then coming down the coast, we find Taiwan just off the eastern coast of China there, and then to the very south of China we have this long country, and that is the country of Vietnam. South of Vietnam we'll find the long island nation of Indonesia. Indonesia is kind of a long name. Indonesia is also kind of a long country with lots and lots of different islands. Now if we turn over towards India, we'll find Bangladesh. Bangladesh is sort of enclosed on three sides by different parts of India. And to the west of India, we'll find Pakistan. Good. Now, let's try out some test questions that you might see. Now, this physical map of Asia can look kind of scary because there's a lot of different features on here. But we're going to simplify things for ourselves. Instead of trying to look at all these different features at once, we're going to focus on each type of feature. And so we can kind of chunk this. You know, take it one step at a time. Let's start by focusing on the rivers. Now, we've got two rivers here that are entirely enclosed in the country. Those are the Huang He River and the Yangtze River. Okay, those two are entirely inside of China. Now, we've got another one that starts in China. That is the Mekong River. It starts in China, but you notice if you follow it down, it actually goes into Southeast Asia. So it's not entirely in China. It actually ends up traveling through Vietnam, Laos, Cambodia, and Thailand. Now if we move over to the west, we'll find the Ganges River, a very important river in India. And also near India, we'll find the Indus River. Indus River, India, Indus, the name is connected for a reason. Okay, now we've got our rivers. Let's take a look at some of the sea-based water. Now, up to the north over here, we'll find the Sea of Japan. It is located right next to, Japan. Yeah, that's, remember, these names, these names for a reason. Okay. Moving to the south a little bit, we'll find the Yellow Sea. That's in between China and Korea, the Korean Peninsula, North and South Korea. And then if we go off the southern coast of China, we have, of course, the South China Sea, because it is south of China. See? Easy. Then if we go over off the coast of India here, we have the Bay of Bengal. Easiest way to remember that is if you happen to remember that Bengal tigers come from India, Bay of Bengal right there. And of course, down here we have the Indian Ocean. Indian Ocean, big ocean, just off of India. See, it's all connected. Now, I've only got a few land-based features that we have to know, so let's take a look at those now. Now, the Himalayan Mountains are right here. The Himalayans form sort of a border in the northeastern part of India, separates India and China right there, sort of in the northeastern part of India. To the north of China, we have the Gobi Desert, very large desert. Very large desert to the north of China. And in the west of China, we have the Taklamakan Desert. Our fourth land feature should be easy to remember, the Korean Peninsula. It's that peninsula that sticks off of the Asian mainland, kind of in the direction of Japan. All right, let's try tackling a couple of test questions regarding